الرجيم بفضل الله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، بارئ الخلائق أجمعين، باعث الأنبياء والمرسلين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا سيد الأنام وصفوة الأنبياء الكرام المحمود الأحمد أبو القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين، لا سيما بقية الله في الأرضين وحجته على العالمين، الحجة ابن الحسن فداه أرواح العالمين، واللعن الدائم على أعدائهم أبد الآبدين ودهر الداهرين. أوصيكم عباد الله ونفسي بتقوى الله. قال مولانا وسيدنا أبو عبد الله جعفر بن محمد الصادق عليه السلام: من زهد في الدنيا أثبت الله الحكمة في قلبه وأنطق بها لسانه وبصره عيوب الدنيا داءها ودواءها وأخرجه الله من الدنيا سالما إلى دار السلام. So of course we are living in this world, so-called dunya. And even if we want hereafter, we have to come through dunya. Dunya is inevitable that we will come here and then we will move to hereafter. So if someone wants to build his hereafter, he needs to come to dunya. However, the problem is when we come here, we think that this is the ultimate perfection for a human being. In other words, this is the end of the world for us. Well, it's not. And that's why we treat dunya as if it will last forever. And we deal with dunya as if we will stay in dunya forever. On the other hand, those who got, alaykum sarahatullah, enlightened hearts know very well that this dunya won't last forever. And they are here to go. They are here not to stay. And that's why they use dunya as much as they need, not as much as they desire. And that's different. I eat as much as I need. Not because the food is delicious, I eat more. I sleep as much as I need. Not because sleep is pleasant, you know, sometimes will make me lazy, that's why I sleep more. No. I try to get a house because I need a shelter. I don't need 50 houses. I only can be in one place. I can't be in 50 places at the same time. So these two different visions and ideologies can help us use dunya for hereafter. So-called in our narrations, dunya balagh, the dunya that can take us to hereafter. Our beloved Imam, al-Imam Ja'far ibn Muhammad al-Sadiq, peace be upon him, says, من زهد في الدنيا أثبت الله الحكمة في قلبه. Whoever uses zuhud, asceticism towards dunya. What does zuhud mean? Zuhud means that showing no interest in dunya. Full stop. I might eat delicious food, but I show no interest in that. I don't travel 150 kilometers to have a, I don't know, camel sandwich. That's a problem. That's not zuhd. Aiming something which is somehow related to dunya, you know, is not zuhd. It's not knowing dunya as it is. Man zahada fi dunya. We want to know dunya, okay? Man zahada fi dunya. We have to show no interest in dunya. Look at that car. Look at that house. Look at, I don't know, that garden. I traveled with a double-decker airplane, so what? Airplane can take you. Normal airplane can take you as well, as much, as long as it's safe. You don't have to be worried about that. Now, some people say, as double-decker, you will find more spaces for salat. That's something else. That's something else, yes. That's right. But no, you know, it's double-decker. It's huge. So what? So what? He has only one kid, but he has, you know, SUV, seven-seater SUV. Why? Why do you need that? Why? You know, it gives me the gist. This is the problem. You are not having zuhd in dunya. I'm not saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish you for that. No, that's something else. It's not about punishment. It's about dunya and what I need. That's the thing. What I need of dunya. Not following my desires. Not showing interest in dunya. I should have no interest in dunya at all. This is zuhd. In two verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in Surah Al-Hadid, مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ فِي كِتَابٍ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَن نَبْرَأَهَا إِنَّ ذَلَكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. Whatever happens to you, any ordeal attacks you, we have wrote that in a book. Before we created heavens. من قبل أن نبرأها. So do you think that you can somehow work in dunya in a way that you can avoid getting trapped by an ordeal? No. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala done that, has wrote that. No one. لا محيص. Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam said, لا محيص من يوم خط بالقلم. You cannot run away from the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has wrote for you. Has written for you. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لِكَيْ لَا تَأْسَوْ عَلَى مَا فَاتَكُمْ وَلَا تَفْرَحُوا بِمَا آتَاكُمْ. So you can avoid getting upset for what you lose, getting happy for what you gain. Not because, you know, you worked a lot and hard, you got what you got. No, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted you to get that. Otherwise, you won't be able to get it. You see people who study very hard. And they are clever, genius. But they can't get a good job. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't want. Rather, you see people that they are not that serious in their studies, works, but they have good positions, good job. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants? That's something else. Too many different reasons for that. So, man zahada fi dunya, it means showing no interest in dunya. Do not chase dunya. Do not feel sorry for what you are not gaining or for your lose. And do not get happy for what you gain. Then Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says, whoever من زاهد في الدنيا أثبت الله الحكمة في قلب. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will plant the wisdom, the tree of wisdom in his heart. Not only that, وَأَنْطَقَ بِهَا لِسَانَهُ. Whenever he talks, you will hear maxims of him. حكمة. Knowledge. Things get, can guide you. Why? Because he's Zahid. Is that all? No. وَبَصَّرَهُ عُيُوبَ الدُّنْيَا دَاءَهَا وَدَوَاهِ. Then he will be able to see the actual face of dunya. You know, the dunya has an actual face. What we see, we see the normal face. But what about the actual face? It's like what? A snake. A snake, when you touch the snake is very soft, but it can kill you. The actual face of dunya, that it can kill you. It betrays you. This is dunya. It won't last for you forever. It won't. بَصَّرَهَا عُيُوبَ الدُّنْيَا. So the first thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you, أَثْبَتَ اللَّهُ الْحِكْمَةِ. You will get the wisdom in your heart. And you will talk wisely. And also, you will be able to see the actual face of dunya. Is that all? بَصَّرَهُ دَاءَ الدُّنْيَا وَدَوَاءَهَا. And you will understand how you can deal with dunya in a way that you won't get trapped by its ordeals. Is that all? No. What else? The fifth thing that Imam Sadiq alayhi salam says, Sallallahu alayhi Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. وَأَخْرَجَهُ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا سَالِمًا إِلَى دَارِ السَّلَامِ. And then you will get out of dunya to hereafter while you have preserved your religion and you get moved to Dar es Salaam, to hereafter. The peace place. Dar es Salaam, peace place. The place that they won't hurt you, punish you. Why? Because you were Zahid in dunya. You show no interest in dunya. You were not chasing dunya. Because if you don't chase the dunya, you won't commit any haram because you know dunya. It's not worth it. Do you think it's worth it to get 1 year passport in Corona era while you were not able to travel? No. A 1 year passport, no, because it's already, you're not allowed to travel for 2 years. All borders were closed. Do you think it's worth it to build a house on the sea without any base, without any foundation? No, you can't. Do you think it's worth it to use the best painting to paint the sea? Ridiculous. This is dunya. This is exactly the meaning of dunya. The meaning of dunya is something that can vanish anytime, anywhere, and for anyone. And it will happen. Suddenly, you see the puzzles that you made. We, all of us, make or made in our minds for our future. Suddenly something happens. No. If someone comes to you and tells you, you know what? This person got cancer. He was diagnosed with cancer and he's in his fourth stage. That's it. The cancer reached the bones. He can do nothing. He's young. He just got a kid. He just got a good job. He just graduated. He's a doctor. So what? So what? Don't forget that you're dealing with God, the Almighty. And He wants to show us that dunya betrays people. So stay away of dunya. And be aware that the dunya can betray you as it betrayed other people. So show no interest in dunya and finish everything. I'm not interested. Really, if someone comes to you and tells you, I can give you $30 billion, and you know that you won't be able to use $30 billion, you say, okay, either I give you that or not. Just put the poor people away and don't think about it. Usually, we don't think about poor people. What should I do with $30 billion? I'm not a government. I don't need that much. Now, if you want, just come and talk to me. If someone goes and he doesn't have a proper plan for that, and usually we don't have a proper plan for $30 billion. That means that he's showing interest in dunya. If someone comes to me and tells me, do you want to be the president, the prime minister? I would say no, because I don't know. I'm not a politician. I'm a scholar. If someone who is mechanic gets the chance to be a king, should he be a king? No. If he accepts to be a king, it means that he's showing interest in dunya, because he can't be a king. So show no interest, zero interest in dunya. Then you will realize and watch and observe the actual face of dunya. May Allah give us the tawfiq to know the dunya and to show no interest in dunya. بحق محمد وآل محمد وهذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. والسلام.